In 2013, over 8,000 people from 1,889 homesteads in 28 villages of Kasonga Parish, Changwali Sub-County in Chikube District, were evicted by the Office of the Prime Minister, accusing them of settling on the Changwali Refugee Settlement camp land illegally. Over 8,000 people, including women and children and the elderly, decided to relocate to the office of the Resident District Commissioner of Chikube, where they have stayed for 1 year. The Chikube District RDC, Amlan Tumsime, has revealed that four of them have so far died from his office, and three of those were children.
We have lost about three children from that place. We have lost an old man who was buried about 2 weeks ago. He was taken to Mubende, to Bugangaizi side for burial. So we have seen baby women producing from the compound. Yet they have their own ancestral land, where they had lived for years and years, even before the coming of any government. Those people have their land. They have G taxes, they can show you. But some few individuals in the OPM, for their self-interest, have decided to make these people suffer. I'm glad the president has intervened.
Are they still?
He has further revealed that the president has intervened in the matter and has hopes that the issue will be settled as soon as possible.
I also want to thank the president for once again asking me, together with his PPS, Dr. Mona, to look into the issue of the Rukinda evictees. These people have suffered for a very long time, and honestly speaking, they have suffered for nothing. They have suffered because of the few individuals in government who are looking at their own selfish interests and ignore the majority. But I'm glad I'm in touch with the PPS. Even today morning we spoke, and we are going to meet, and we are going to ensure that these people get justice at last. I have all the hopes that they will have to go back to their land. Because even the law, the Land Act protects them. So I am very confident that the president is going to solve this problem.
Birunji Asimwe, one of the affected persons, says they decided to come to the office of the RDC because it was the only place they could run to. We decided to come to the office of the RDC because we could not see ourselves dying without seeking help. The victims revealed that their land is being utilized by unknown people, yet the Prime Minister stopped all activities on the land. Let people go back to their lands. Let's take these OPM officials who committed atrocities to authorities and let the refugees be relocated to another land. Right now, our land has been rented out to other people for cultivation, yet the Prime Minister halted all activities on the contested land. They cut down all our fruit trees we left behind, yet the President issued directives in 2016 to let them be returned to our land, but nothing has been done. Who is above the President's directive?
Directive of President is that you can't make it.
After sleeping at the office of the RDC for a year, the biggest challenge they are facing is lack of water and proper sanitation, housing facilities and food, among others. Most of the energetic people are currently working as casual laborers in the nearby gardens to feed the elderly and children. Report by Godfrey Muhumza for the news.